there somewhere. It's all waiting if you keep believing. So don't run, don't hide, it will be alright, you'll see. Trust me, I'll be there watching over you. Just take a look through my eyes. There's a better place somewhere out there. Just take a look through my eyes. Everything changes, you'll be amazed what you find if you look through my eyes.
You to listen to the following discussion entitled Love is the Greatest Law in the Universe by Supreme Master Ching Hai with association members in Singapore on September the 26th, 1994.
I'm very happy for Singapore and for her people. That the country is so developed, so orderly, managed, yeah, and the people are so free. I mean, of course, you still have a lot of laws, yeah. That is inevitable because many people don't want to live an orderly and peaceful life. They want to try to risk, to have dangerous enterprise and undertaking, yeah. So for these people, the laws are necessary, yeah, so that the orderly person, the orderly citizen who respect peaceful and free life will not be in danger, right? So of course we have to understand that. But still, something lingering in the air, you know, make you feel very nervous, feel not relaxing. Huh? In Singapore, you don't have this feeling. Is that not so?
Yes. Yes.
Yesterday I talked to some of the our disciples at home, yeah, our fellow practitioners, and she told me, in Singapore, whatever the government say, we okay. Is that right?
Yes.
Yes, that's good for you. Because the government here only does good, you know. That's why you trust the government. It's not that whatever the government say, you okay, but the government has earned your trust. Is that not so?
Yes. Yes.
And of course there's sometimes mistake here and there or something. Sometimes has not tried and tested, so the people would voice their opinion. But if it's good, you know, I think the Singapore people are very supportive of the government. And that's what makes Singapore strong. You know what I mean? It's not the government alone, it's you, the people, that make Singapore strong and prosperous and united. That's how you're strong, because you're united. Similarly, in the spirit, if we are together, you know, in one spirit and one goal, and then we will achieve the greater benefit for ourselves and for whomever we love to share this benefit with, whomever like to share this benefit with us. You have always noticed that if the people who always come to the group meditation, right, doesn't matter how she or he was before, they will improve. Is that not so? Yes. Because to be together with the friends that have the same idea with you is really tremendous support and benefit to you. Even if in the mundane way, you can see how your nation grows. Yeah. because people are united and one mind together, working under the government's leadership, then we have no problem. Because in Asia, even though we are developed like Singapore, I feel the people are still very warm together, you know. We still have neighbors kind, yes, and we still treasure a lot of value of, you know, spiritual value, as well as the old heritage of our ancestors. Some nice customs and some of the warm relationship between human beings. You are very developed, but you don't have this cold, cut off relationship between neighbors. Is that also a friend between the citizens, you know, at large? You still kind of tie together somehow, huh? Not because of responsibility, not because of the shared border, you know, shared country, but because it is natural that the, and it's not only in Singapore, in Korea, in Taiwan, in Thailand, in Hong Kong. You grow by yourself. I don't really take care. Is that not so? I only come now and again, make sure the children are all right. Without the support of our community and our like-minded friends, it is very lonely to walk the spiritual path. Mm-hmm. You understand? Especially when we are just a beginners and we have not yet the full development of an adult, I'll say, a spiritual practitioner. You imagine your family, right? You are married, yeah? Many of you are married. And then if your family is in harmony and everything you do together is smooth, then you feel more energetic, right? And everything you do, it is easier to be successful. Also, when you encounter some of the difficulty, it feels easier for you to overcome. Is that not so? But when you have disharmony in the family, then it's very difficult. Doesn't matter what you do. You seem like not wanting to do anymore. And then it seems like impossible for you to achieve any result. Is that not so? Yeah. So much more if we want to walk all the way to the spiritual mansion of the Most High. If you have companion, you know what I mean? Supporting in spirit. It is very, very incredible. And it is the energy that each of us radiated, you know, it is incredible when it's put together. For example, the water, you know, if it's only one cup, it's not much. Is that not so? It's okay, it's fill the cup. It's fill the cup and it's all right for the cup. But when many cups put together, you know, many hundreds of thousands of cups put together, it becomes a swimming pool. And then more, then it will become lake, and then it become river, and it become ocean. You understand what I mean? So that's why the group meditation is extremely, extremely important to you. And you probably have learned that by your own experience. Is that not so?
Yes.
You feel cleansed, energized when you go out. Is that not so?
Yes.
It is because you share energy. It's all right, you say, well, one cup is okay, you know, two cups, all right. But one cup you cannot clean. But if you put together, it become, you know, a lake. All of you can swim in it, and it's still there. You know what I mean? But if you just pour one cup on your body, not only your body is not cleansed, but the cup is gone, the water is gone. You know what I mean?
Yes.
So it is a privilege for us to go to group meditation. It is really, really a great benefit to mankind as well. Because if the lake is there, not only you will benefit, but many other people in the society who doesn't put water in the lake can also get benefit. Is that not so?
Yes.
Recently, our world has a lot of disaster, like drought, then also, and then dry climate, heated up planet due to a lot of weather changing. Yeah, because we have abused so many of the natural resources, as well as some of the disaster from nature, like burning forests, and then that reduce a lot of rain, yeah, and that in turn also heat up our planet, yeah, and then the more it heat up, the more dry, the less trees, the less rain, the less tree, and this is the devil's circle. And every corner of the earth affect the whole planet. You can know it. You know it very well, because recently the fire in Indonesia, huh? You know, huh?
Yes.
Affect the whole Singapore, no?
Yes.
And Malaysia and the neighboring, eh? So actually, from these kind of natural lessons, we can tell that one person or one place of this planet will affect other part of our planet. Is that not so? Therefore, if you are you yourself, your heart, your mind, your speech, your action are pure, how much beneficial can it be to this planet? This is very logical. We have no need to argue or to demonstrate. Is that not so? For example, every place has its own atmosphere. Is that not so? Okay. So when you go into the funeral service or a hospital, yeah, you feel different from when you go into a church. Is that not so? Or when you go into the slaughterhouse, yeah, where all the animals are killed for meat, you feel different. I don't know if you can feel, but I feel. Do you feel? Can you feel?
Yes.
Yes, of course, huh? For example, last time we went to the Hong Kong refugee camp, huh? The Whitehead Center. Oh, right there. It's really a terrible feeling, you know. I could not help but just keep crying. I have no voice to even sing. I was choked, you know, with the atmosphere of the camp. Of course, we can rise ourselves above it, but since we want to share the suffering and we want to understand the suffering of other beings, then we can feel it. You know what I mean? If you don't want to have anything to do with it, of course you can rise above it and have nothing to do with it. Like the lotus in the muddy water, you don't have to be contaminated. But since we live in this world, we want to share, you know, happiness as well as sorrow with our fellow brothers and sisters, and we will feel the difference between each place in this planet. That is because atmosphere is different from different places. The atmosphere created by this group of people is different from the atmosphere that created by another group of people or another person. Sometimes you come and see a friend or a relative just before they even spoke anything. You just hold their hands, you feel what they feel. Is that not so? There is a man in America. He was very bad boy when small. Since his childhood, he just hit anybody or punch anybody that happened to make him you know, angry or not to his liking, and he just hit them. And he was a kind of very violent person. Until one day, he got struck by the lightning from heaven, that he was dead for a while. Kind of, you know, declared dead by doctors, you know, near-death experience. And then between that, he went to heaven, yeah? He went to a place, and then other beings tell him, if they show him the kind of life that he has led up to now, you know, violence and unfair and suppressing people and things like that. And then afterward, they told him, if you continue like this, all the disaster will be upon you. And then they also show him a kind of a lot of disaster going on in the world, you know, from that time up to present time. Most of the things that has been shown to him has already happened. They told him that if you continue your life like you have done, all this disaster will be upon you. So of course he made it good and he tried to, you know, change his way of life. Then afterward, because of promise to change his way of life, God has given him a lot of ability, including the ability to read other people's mind and to know their sickness and to know what they have done in that day. So whenever a person comes to him, just come to him and just hold their hands and you know what happened to that person that day, exactly everything. We should go to the group meditation together. It should really intentionally try, you know, to be with the group and do exactly the same thing, keeping ourselves pure, speech, body and mind, as well as the spirit, purify ourselves. Otherwise there is no use to come to the group meditation because we will not progress. Understand? Keeping our way. If a teacher tries to teach you English and tell you to do homework every day, and then even ABC you don't want to learn, and then what is the use of showing up at the class every day and making trouble for the teacher, for wasting the time of other roommates, because they also have to share their time with you. When people come into group meditation, at that time they want to develop super worldly knowledge.
My first question is, dear Grand Master, can you please enlighten me as to whether the method, convenient method for me, is truly safe? That is, will it affect one's mentality, become mentally unbalanced? Is there anything to fear when practicing this method? Kindly pardon me for asking. I'm quite apprehensive, that is, nervous, going into the unknown. Thank you.
Oh. It scares me. Do you have any mental problem? By the way? No problem. I say no problem. Well, see, they already practiced many years. And they say, no problem. So you should believe your own citizen, all right? If I say something, you say, oh, she's a foreigner. This is all Singapore people. You all right, huh?
Yes.
No mental disorder?
No.
No depression?
No.
What do you get after that?
Happiness.
Enjoy.
Enjoy.
What else?
More intelligent.
More intelligent. I doubt it. What else?
Blissful.
What fast? Moving fast. What word only? Do things fast.
Okay.
What else?
Effective.
See
beyond.
Huh?
See beyond the world.
See beyond the world. Oh, that. Oh, that system a little bit higher.
Okay.
Beyond the world, you see that? Wow. What is beyond there?
Crystal Palace.
Huh?
Crystal Palace.
Crystal Palace? Oh, okay. Because you like crystal. There are diamond palaces you didn't see. It's very cheap still. What else?
Wiser.
Oh, that's more intelligent. Oh, no, not different. Different. Okay, wiser. Anything else? Huh?
More compassionate.
More compassionate? Oh, wow, really? Alright. Okay, brother, sister, that's what you get after initiation. You're more loving, yeah? More intelligent, more efficient, and faster in everything you do. So don't worry. Nobody has gone to the mental hospital so far. Including me. Okay. I'm a longest practitioner here and I don't think anything happened to me yet. Up to now, not yet. Yeah? Maybe in the future. Maybe in the future I will go too fast, huh? I probably cannot live in this world anymore. That probably happened. That's the only setback that we have after initiation. Probably we need a lot of patience to stay in this world again and, you know, continue our work. But we do it. Hmm? Anybody quit their job because of initiation? Huh?
No.
No. No, you continue your work, huh? Is that right?
Yes.
Okay, la. Very good, love. Continue, love.
Can people who have previous experiences with drugs make progress in meditation if they resolve to change themselves?
Yes, they can. But difficult for them. They need a lot of willpower and strong determination to change their life. Otherwise, very difficult. Drug, in the beginning, offers people some kind of bliss, you know, and then they think this is heaven, and then they like it, and then they take more and more, and then they become addicted to it. These people are very, very pitiful. All they wanted is heaven. They feel so much pressure in this world, and then they want to have blissful feeling, but they went to the wrong store. Our drugstore is better. Everlasting, no side effect. Yeah. Everlasting bliss, no side effect, and improving every day. The drug make it degrade you every day and drag you down and down and down. It's terrible.
Dear Master, how did God get created in the first place? Can you talk about the first Master to grace the earth?
Wow. I wasn't there. I'm younger than all of you. And you ask me such a question, I'm supposed to ask you, you have gray hair, the one that. Sir, can you tell us what happened? In the beginning, always God is enjoying himself. Hmm? God is the greatest energy that pervades all the universe. And the energy, when it's rested, you know, is not stirring, nothing comes out of it. But within this energy, there are a lot of seeds, you know what I mean? Different seeds. And then when it stirs, this God energy, or God stirs, or wakes up, we call it wakes up, God wakes up, and then everything sprung out to existence. And then according to the seeds, it sprung out into different shape, different forms, yeah? Different construction, and then so we become like this, and the universe has come into being, okay? And after sometimes, probably God sleeps again, and everything comes back to sleep, and then after sometimes, spring back again. It's very difficult to explain this in human language because it's something mystical. We can say something scientifically, like. It's very similar, like the theory of the Big Bang, you know? Hmm? And then this is called God, okay? The sleeping energy, the dormant energy. And when awakened, then everything comes into being according to the quality inside the seeds, yeah?
How to heal the pride and hatred? Thank you, Master.
Meditation. Huh? Meditation will help you. Help you in many, many ways and erase a lot of bad habits. Yeah? Pride is also a habit. Yeah? You were not born with pride. You were not born with arrogance. You were not born with hatred. These are only accumulated habits which you receive during your life, because you have come in contact with other people or the circumstances, and then consequently you derive the side effect of these interrelationship with the situation or with other beings, you know what I mean? So this is only a habit, and habit we can change. We can cultivate a saint of ourselves, or we can make a sinner our us. This is only the choice. All right?
You see, the cows, the pigs, they donate organs every day. And they're not afraid of the karma. Of course, when it's not necessary, and you try to overdo things, and when you do things, you do charitable acts, you expect the rewards, you know, that I'm a good person, I'm a bodhisattva, I'm a saint, and God will love me more, God will give me more money and things like that. Then that is karma. But when you do it out of love, you know, love is the greatest law in the universe. Anything can be cleansed away by true love. So when you do things in a charitable manner, do it with love. Don't worry about karma. If I worry about karma, I would not dare to come out and give you initiation. Huh? Because a lot of karma.
In the Bible, it is written that God told Noah that meat will also be food for him and his descendants. I don't believe God will give such an allowance, perhaps unless for some special reason.
Meat?
I find it hard to explain to my Christian friend. Could you please enlighten me? Thank you.
Well, God had told Noah to place, to store a lot of things in the ship, yeah? And meat not necessarily always means flesh, yeah? In the ancient Bible, ancient language, the word for meat means meals, meal, M-E-A-L, meal, food, yes. For example, the Indian people would tell you, in India they call some kind of candy, sweet meat. Huh? Is that not so, sister? Yeah, they call it sweet meat. And all the Indian master, most famous and non-famous, and all the sadhus and all the gurus, they eat sweet meat. Would you say they eat meat? Huh? Understand what I mean? Huh?
Yes. Have you been to India? You eat that kind of sweet meat. Very sweet. Terribly sweet. Sweeter than sugar. That will make you never forget India. Once you eat it, you never forget India. It's so sweet. And they call it sweet meat. Okay? For example, like that. And therefore, the kind of meat that God wants Noah to put not necessarily means flesh, means food. All right. Well, many things in the Christian Bible is difficult for the lay person to understand. But let's put it this way. Even if God allows us to eat meat, you know, out of our own love individually, God will not forbid you not to eat meat, all right? Because if you love your dog, for example, you ride dogs and cats, you wouldn't want to kill them and eat them.
So why discriminate between a dog, a cat, your pet birds, and other outside birds, and outside cats, dogs, or other animals like, like chickens and ducks and, ox and cows, something like that. You know what I mean? The way you love your dogs and your cats and your children, you could also love a cow and a pig, okay? So that's the way of love. Therefore, because of this law of love alone, we would not believe that God would let us kill animal and eat. Also in the Bible, God already said very clearly, who told you to kill all this she, goat, and he, buffalo, to make offering to me. Stop this killing of the innocent lives. Otherwise, when you pray to me, I will not listen. God said that clearly. So no need to ask me any of this fundamental question. You should read more the Bibles. Yes, because in the Bible, there are many, many hints inside. Not only hints, very obvious statement that God say we don't touch meat. Meat for the belly and the belly for the meat, and God will destroy both meat and them. Is that not so? That means don't touch meat. Also he say don't mix around with the people who eat meat and drink wine. Is that not so?
Yes.
That's very clear. So how would he say that and then give Noah meat? Huh? Must be a very contradictory God. Who care about that kind of God, if he really exists? We just care more consistency, okay? In the Bible, mention about meat very few, mention about vegetarian a lot. I have already made some references for you in the why do we need to eat vegetarian. Remember?
Yes.
All right.
Could you explain about the end of the world?
Even if the world ends, you're not willing to let go of Singapore and go to heaven? Huh?
Yeah.
Anyhow, yeah. We can change the end of the world. We are changing it. But without evidence, I don't want to speak about these things. You know what I mean? Predictions also have come true in the past. Like Nostradamus, he has predicted many things and they have come true. So it could be that the end of the world also come true. Because the way we are abusing our planet, the way we are building bombs, yeah, the way we are affecting ourselves, killing ourselves, damaging our spirit, body and minds with drugs, yeah, with a lot of negative thinking, yeah, and murdering each other and destroying forests for rising animals, yeah, and killing mass animals and things like that, or mass killing human beings through wars, ignorance, then the world might end very soon. Don't have to ask me. You are all intelligent people. You read newspapers, you can church very accurately, you read a lot of books and a lot of news about our environment, about how hazardous we have made our environment become. We have even, damaged the ozone layer which protects our earth, for example, like that. And we indulge ourselves in a lot of misconduct, which consequently brings disease and disaster into our lives and into our family lives. So the way it is, the world might end. Huh? If not by bomb, then by disease, by self-destructive habits and selfish tendency of human beings. But we could change it. We could avert this disaster. If we love our planet so much, then we have to purify ourselves. Understand? So that the atmosphere of this planet will become reasonable for us to live in and for our children to grow in. And that's the way we avert the end of the world. Otherwise, even if I say to you, the world will not end, or the world will end, it makes no difference. You know what I mean? We will end our own world if we continue the way we behave. You know, like the people sometimes in the society they behave. But we are changing it. You know, our world is changing for the better. And I hope it will change for better and better still. And this I have to thank you, because you have made the change. Not only in Singapore people, I mean, I thank our fellow practitioners for helping me to help the world. They change their own atmosphere, they become loving, and they radiate great love into the world, into their environment, you know? And the world has changed a lot, has changed a lot. Huh? So many changes, big changes. Huh? I hope the more people practice loving kindness, the more people radiate heavenly loving kindness light toward the earth, the world will become better, and we don't have to experience the apocalypse. Alright? So you are changing it. You are changing it. But subtly and is no evidence. We cannot prove it. We can only know it with the meditation knowledge, when we see inside what's happening. And I really thank you very much for being so sincerely in your practice, and that you have helped me a lot with the people in the world, with the disaster victims, bringing your love to different corners of the world. Without you, I alone cannot do it, because I'm only one person. I can direct, I can instruct, I can encourage you, and I can reason to you, telling you what is good, and then you do it, and then it's good, okay? So, I really have to thank you, all right? Anyhow, thank you for going to Cambodia, some of you, and that fulfilled my wish to help the people in Cambodia, Singapore. Disciples. Some of them go to Cambodia and help with the flood victims.
You have said that you don't belong to any religion, but you have said the importance of Tao. Please explain further.
Because Tao don't belong to any religion. Huh? Tao or God or Buddha don't belong to any religion. Okay? So I don't belong to any religion. Sometimes I say Tao, sometimes I say God, sometimes I say Buddha. It's not a name. It's not a name for the Almighty God. It's not a name for the Buddha nature. I don't really belong to any religion, because Christ don't belong to any religion also. Buddha doesn't belong to any religion. Huh? Nobody belongs to any religion. And what is religion? It's just a kind of a way of life. Yeah, a godly way of life that we should follow. Any religion teach us this godly way of life. That is the true religion. And true religion, only one. Therefore, we don't need to say that we belong to this religion or that religion. Okay, all religion are one. Good religion are one. And a misunderstanding coming between, because we human beings sometimes ignorant. We interpret different scriptures in a different level, all right, and then we make difference. For me, there's no difference, no different religion, only one. Ah, 你不懂英文啊? Huh? 不太懂啊? 你是问那个道的问题是不是? 问那个道的问题是不是? 啊哈, 我就说那个道不用, 是一个名字而已嘛, 哎, 不一定道就是道教，道是一条路嘛，任何的所谓的宗教就是主那条路而已，就名字不一样，有时候 in Singapore 人家那个英文讲那个 water 嘛，中文讲是水嘛，事实上只一样一个品质呢，那个道不是。 佛心，或是上帝的品质，天堂都差不多了，因为我们自己比较无大懂，然后变成很多分别，所以我才说我没有什么宗教分别，因为我认为任何宗教都指那条路，就我们比较懂不一样，然后开始挣扎。那佛没生出来以前没有佛教吗？耶稣没有生出来以前没有耶稣基督教吗？ 懂哈，后来人家才选名字，为了那些名师的名字而已哈，所以任何宗教都差不多了。OK，
Dear Master, Master, you said war is mainly due to meat eating. Master, can you enlighten me the reasons behind it?
Because of the karma, because of the law of karma, if thou shalt not kill, we should not kill other beings. If we killed, then that will bounce back to us. For example, in scientific research, they say that if you throw something into the air, and then you stand there and throw something into the space, and after some time, long time, it will come back to you. So that is scientifically proved, the law of karma. as you saw, so shall you. Whatever you give out will come back to you eventually. I tell you, at Christmas time, many people buy presents. And one give present to another. And then sometimes they find the present come back to them. Okay?
Dear Master, I'm not here, I think this is a quotation, I'm not here to change you all into disciples, I'm here to help you all to become masters. These two sentences I'm not so clear about. Please explain.
If a teacher teach somebody English, huh? It is with the aim that maybe later he master English, no? At least he's a teacher himself, for himself, right? He become master in English, no? He master the English, and then he can speak fluently. And he will master the English. So I teach you this science of life. So later you will master this science. So whether you keep it to yourself or to use it to, in dealing with the universal brotherhood or teach it to somebody else. Okay? That is, of course, the aim of every teacher. No? Alright? This is very clear. I cannot keep you forever as a disciple. You can't keep your children, you know, child forever for yourself, so that you become grandparents, but you want them to grow up, and then later teach them everything that you know about life.
All right, then they will become parents themselves. Is that not so? Also very clear. Okay.
Although I have not been initiated, but yesterday night when I was meditating, I can feel Master's presence. Because the time is short, I will give details later. I have one question that when I'm in meditation, in my brain there is some sound, whether it will affect meditation. This sound will appear when I'm in silence.
No, this is called the sound of silence. It's okay. This is okay. It's okay. When we are still, yeah, and the still voice, which is the voice of God, without voice, without alphabetic phonetic emphasis will come to our consciousness. This is the teaching of God, okay? So just accept it, enjoy it. That will make you wiser, because God don't teach in language. God will teach you with this kind of musical vibration. And then you will be very happy. Okay? Don't worry. When you still, you have this blessing, then Master will have you stupidly open your wisdom. That's when you can see the light and you can hear the sound. And that can be done also with or without the Master presence. The real Master don't have to be present to give the initiation. And don't have to give you an official initiation also. All right? Can do it under any circumstances. But if you want to develop further, you want to be more sure of what you learn, you should come to the physical master and then learn some more instruction and then practice further, and then later you get more clear. That's all right?
I have been initiated, so the five generations will be liberated. But my sister and brother-in-law, will they be liberated? Because from young they have been looking after me.
Yes, they will. Okay, there will be. Whomever you love and wanted to be with them, they will get also the blessing. They share it with you. Alright? God's blessing is immense. It's not individual. Okay? You can share it with a lot of people and it never gets lesser. It doesn't become less. It might become even more. Okay?
You are the Supreme Master. Why do you need to see a doctor?
It's not I who want to see the doctor. It's my instrument that get damaged. If you're healthy, but your car tire blow up, please go to see the expert to fix your tire. Is that not so? Don't say because you're an excellent driver or you are the president of the United States and when your tire blow up, you don't bother to go to see the mechanic.
This question is from another initiate. Dear Supreme Master, as a businessman traveling often, I have problem keeping the precepts of vegetarianism. the precepts, for example, vegetarianism. Could I join in the group meditation before initiation?
Will you do that?
No.
We are democratic. We uphold democracy. If the citizens say no, it's no. All right. By the way, being a businessman is not, you know, an obstruction to your spiritual progress. Yeah? All these people are businessmen. Huh? Big businessmen. Oh, standing over there are all the businessmen. You see that? Yeah. The driver who drove me here today, you to be my driver, he's a big businessman in Singapore, for example, huh? And it's a lawyer. I don't remember many because I don't care what they're doing, really. I don't know how much money they earn, but if they happen to work close to me, for example, like a contact person, the brother Joe, he's a big businessman. His business spread over 2-3 countries, not only one. See? But he still looks healthy, no? Looks handsome, huh? If you come for initiation and be with a group, you will know many distinguished personalities in the society sitting next to you. And you will also realize that they are highly developed soul. You know, they're great saints of a modern time. They don't look like a saint, but they are real saints. But you can tell them to grow a beard and put up a turban so it looks a bit more like the Bodhisattva of India. Otherwise, they are truly saints, saintly people. You know, the saints in the past are also like this. Except they wear different clothes perhaps and it makes them look probably more dignified. Yeah? But these are the saints. And these saintly people walk, breathe and talk to you in the ordinary language and live in an ordinary way the way you do. So if they can do it, you can. Yeah? Many business people and politicians, they also live in a very active, busy and helpful life to the society. But they're also vegetarian. They travel from one country to the next. Sometimes I have one disciple, he only lives in a hotel. He never lives at home. He has no time. He has no home. His homes are the hotels. Everywhere he goes, he stays in hotels, a few days, a few weeks, and then he goes to another country because he has to make banking negotiation for the World Bank, yeah? And the World Bank are really the World Bank. They have everywhere in the world. And he's highly representative. He has to go make different connection and different transaction for the bank. Therefore, he can never stay at home. He only stay in hotel. And he's very strong, healthy, and sufficient, and efficient. Every aspect of his life, nothing affect him. And he eat cheese, you know, whatever the hotel afford. And then sometimes he bring his wife to cook for him. Sometimes he go out in the vegetarian restaurant and eat them. All right? So find a way for yourself. If you want God above everything else, you don't mind to sacrifice a few pieces of beef.
Wonderful Master. I have no question to ask. But Master, I wish to take this opportunity to thank you on behalf of my family and myself for the peace and happiness we have at home and outside. My dear Master, I met you yesterday. I met you face to face, but was shocked and lost and couldn't speak to thank you. Once again, I thank you, my beloved Master.
Help I can be to you, I'll be honored to offer. Besides, I'm only an instrument. We are all instruments in different degrees. If God can make use of this instrument to spread His love and blessing to you, this is only God's doing. And we should only thank God. All right. The master is not the physical body, it's God who used the physical body, all right? But that's why I ask you why you want to see me. When I first came in, I can never get over this. Why you want to see me? You know, why? In person, because, I don't know why, because you always have tapes and video, that should be enough. Huh? And you should follow my teaching, not follow me.
Dear Master, are every event which occur to us in this world God's plan? Are these things all good for us? Or every event?
Every event. Well, something are good for us, something are not good for us. Yes. We come to this world to do something. We have promised God to join in the supportive spirit of the plan of the creation. And we volunteer to come here to bless the planet and to carry out God's mission to improve the plan of creation, to do something. But then after we're born, we forget. Yeah? Sometimes we do things not according to God's will, and then we cause problems for ourselves and for other people. And then God has to correct it somehow. You know what I mean? One way or another. And sometimes the correction brings pains to us, you know, bodily as well as mentally. We do also something wrong. And sometimes we don't listen to the inner voice of God and we forget our promise. We forget our noble purpose. We do something that is not good for us and not good for other people. At that time, God will send someone else, another volunteer, to come down, probably, and to correct the situation. And sometimes, because of this mission to correct the situation, the person suffers from a lot of trouble. You know what I mean? Of his mission, he has to suffer and sacrifice too. That's why we see a lot of disaster and sometimes a very unhappy, unfortunate events happen in this world. But whatever happened, the best thing is just to surrender to God's will. Yeah? Just do our best and try to keep to the non-violence path. And sooner or later, God will straighten it out for us. If we try to do it ourselves, then we probably can do it, but then we will bring some more mistakes into the situation. Or sometimes we bring the karma upon ourselves. Yeah?
At present, I am a non-vegetarian. Can I be initiated immediately and then be a vegetarian slowly?
If you want to be initiated immediately, then you have to start vegetarian immediately. Not slowly, okay? Because the vegetarian diet is good for you. It will purify your spirit, purify your aura and make you clear inner and outside and protect you. It's not only for me, it's not for the precepts that you should eat vegetarian. It's for the loving kindness to other beings, like animals, that you should be vegetarian, all right? It's not a bargain, it's not a supermarket. You should read more book before you want to be initiated, huh? Why we are vegetarian. And if you can do it, if you agree to it, then you should be initiated. There's no rush and no how say, forcing you. You should know clearly why you want to be initiated. You want God more than anything else.